Hello and welcome back to my channel. At the end of this video, you will have four ways for creating line path animations to move objects in stages in PowerPoint. There are various reasons one may want to use line path animations over several stages. For example, one may want to illustrate how information or an object progresses through a process. PowerPoint's abilities does not cease to amaze me. Everything I described in this video is also available in a mini course, and I give instructions on how to access it at the end of this video. The first way, freehand. One could create a freehand custom path animation along the route that you want your object to move. Simply select the object that you want to animate, select Animations, Motion Path, and Custom Path. To start your path, click on the center of your object, click where you want to make the first turn, draw in a different direction, click at the next turn, and change your direction again, and so forth. At the end, give a double click. Go to settings and refine the timings of your animation. This animation has the drawback that there are no pauses at the various stations along your route. To overcome this, there are three techniques that one can use, and I'll explain all three. Use the morph transition. The morph transition works by gradually changing the position of an object on a slide to a different position on another slide. Normally, the position of an object will be just here on the slide, and then on the next slide, the position of the object will be here. The morph transition from one slide to the next creates the illusion of movement from point A to point B. One could use the morph transitions to depict an object moving from station to station by creating several slides, each with the object at a different station on a different slide. By setting the transition times, the amount of time paused at each station is now firmly in your hands. By setting the length of the morph transition, you determine how quickly or slowly the movement is. Unfortunately, you can't control the slow start and slow stop that is built into the morph transition. This hardly ever bothers me, so this is my go-to technique for linear path animations. Another downside is you require multiple slides to move just one object. If anything changes, say the title of your presentation, you have to change all slides. The third way, to eliminate the slow start, slow end effect built into the morph transition, one could create several slides, each with a line path starting where the object ended on the previous slide. The drawback with this approach is that the start location of the object on the subsequent slide should correspond exactly with the end location of the previous slide. Some tricks to achieve this is to create some dummy objects, like the one that you want to animate, and place them at the stations where you want the animations to start and finish. Delete these dummy objects later. That is the purpose of these little yellow boxes. Another trick includes setting up grid lines and snap to grid option to achieve some accuracy. To activate grid lines, go to View and select Grid Lines. To ensure objects snap to your grids, select the option here. A further drawback to this technique is that once again, you have to work with several slides. To overcome this, a fourth way can be used. The fourth way is to create multiple line path animations for an object. This process is a bit fiddly, but yields the most economic results. So please be prepared to practice a bit. Start by adding the first line path animation to your object and set the red end mark to where the first movement should end. Now use add animation to add a second and subsequent line path animations to your object that you want to move along a path. One should carefully adjust some things. The start marks of each line path, it is the green dots that is indicated when you select an animation in the animation pane, or when you select a path in your slide. Remember, the shortcut to your animation pane is Alt A and then C. Now carefully position your cursor so that it makes these two pointed arrows, and that indicates that you can drag the dot. Also, carefully adjust the stopping marks for each path. it is these red dots. The red ending mark of a part should line up with the green starting mark of the next part. As I said, getting everything lined up can be a bit fiddly, so work with a screen magnification that is comfortable. Another thing to remember, when your screen gets crowded with lots and lots of objects, hide some of them by setting the eyes off, or at least lock them in place so that you don't accidentally move things around that shouldn't be moved. Your selection pane to achieve this is achieved with Alt plus F10. Everything I tried to explain in this video is covered in a free mini Moodle course that you can access by following the link in the description below. When you complete the course, you will earn this badge. What is your most useful PowerPoint animation? Please tell everybody in the comments below. Please also like, subscribe, and share this video with others that may find it useful. Remember to also visit my Udemy course on the subject of PowerPoint animations. Even if you only want to look at some of the free preview lessons that I've included in the course, you are welcome to redeem the coupon that is in the link in the description below. Thank you very much.